Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to do a get ready with me for a video call. I have a video call with some colleagues. It's nothing special, so I can go a little bit more colorful today, as you saw I did. But for this video, I'm only going to use makeup from black owned makeup brands. I have a lot of stuff. I have Proper Beauty, a few lippies from Proper Beauty. I have the Colored Rain palette. I have a lot of Juvia's Place palettes, and I also have the Juvia's Place concealer. I'm going to use some Fenty, and I am going to use some OPV Beauty. So if you want to know how I got this look and what I think about these brands, then please keep on watching. Hi, my name is Anne Chris, and on this channel I try to give you some inspiration on how to play with colorful makeup but also keep it elegant and sophisticated. I try out a lot of new makeup, especially from Indian high-end brands. So if this is something that sounds interesting to you, if you need some inspiration on how to play with those fun colors but you want to keep it a little bit more work appropriate, then please consider subscribing, because I upload 2 to 3 times a week. And without further ado, as I said, I have a lot of stuff. I don't think I was able to use everything because I have these stunning lashes from OPV Beauty, but you know, I can't wear that to work. I'm sorry. So that is not going to happen, but the rest I did use. I swatched all these Proper Beauty lippies. I'm wearing one of them right now, and I also swatched the Colored Rain Queendom lippy as well. So let's just jump into the video. Let's dive into this look. Before I'm going to jump into the video, I just want to say that everything I touch on in this video is my opinion. If you are not agreeing with that, that's fine. If you are thinking, girl, you need some education, that is also fine. Leave me a comment down in the description box. I would love to chat with you. I would love to have that conversation, but please keep it civil. But if you don't, I'm just going to block you and delete your comment. I'm that simple. So let's jump into the makeup. Let's do a looksy look. I am going to go into the Safari Rain palette from Colored Rain. This is a limited edition palette, and I think it's sold out. So it's done and gone. And I knew it was going to be the last stock. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to get this. I am going to get this palette because I want it. It has this great reviews. I want it. So this is the palette, and I think I'm just going to start off with this color because I think I'm going to do something green, because I also have a pigment from OPV Beauty, and it is like a neon green, and I'm going to use that as a like liner accent. And I think it would be best to use that with a green. So I am going to do this with a green. I have a video call, as I said. I have a video call in a few hours, I think. Yeah, in a few hours. It's just with some colleagues, so I can go a little bit like experimental today, but not too much, because it still has to be a little bit work appropriate. And I'm going to go into this color, and it's named Clay. And I'm going to lay that in my outer corner and into my crease a little. So yeah, let's start with that. Ooh, nice. I have a lot of stuff, and I don't even think I am going to be able to use it all, but I want to do this like buying from black owned makeup brands more. When the George Floyd murder happened and the support from the community came in and people were doing these videos, I was like, oh cool, I want to do like a get ready with me with black owned makeup brands, because I want to support, I want to show my love for, and I think it's very important to, you know, let your voice be heard, and especially on matters like these. And so I was like, okay, I want to do that. And then I wanted to pull together a full face of makeup, and I was like, I don't even own that much black owned brands. The only thing I think I had was from H Beauté, the Flare palette. I have some Fenty, and that's just part owned by Rihanna, not even like fully owned by Rihanna. And I had some Juvia's Place, but that was it. And a Pat McGrath palette. That was it. So I was like, okay, this is not going to do a full face of makeup, so I have to go and shop. And the thing is, for me, I am not really a extremely conscious of race or of like, you're black, I'm not. So I don't want to sound like I'm holier than holy, but usually I'm not really that, I don't want to say concerned, but I'm not really busy or not really occupied with the fact that you are from a different race or a different color than me. I don't really care. So same goes for, I am not really that conscious of buying makeup that is from black owned makeup brands. There were these lists on Instagram from black owned makeup brands, so you could see, okay, what is black owned, where do you want to buy stuff, and I went a little bit ham. But I love it. I love, you know, knowing now the backstory behind a brand and knowing it's black owned, and 9 out of 10 times it's all women. It's, I think everything I have here is like all like also black women owned. So that is, I think, really cool as well. So yeah, I was like, okay, I am going to be more conscious of that, and I'm going to just buy more from black owned makeup brands. So I'm really going to do videos like this more, and I don't know if I'm going to shout it out like I'm doing only black owned makeup brands, but I am going to be, for me, more conscious of what I'm buying and seeing if I can support black owned brands, because that is thing, I think that is really important, and I want to do that. I'm not saying everybody should, I'm just saying that I want to do that. This color goes very well with my shirt. I have to see, I think I want to go into the greens in this palette, especially this like army green. It's called Combo Basin. I want to go into this color. I'm going to go and put this in my crease and a little bit in the outer corner, but I am putting a little bit too much in the outer corner as well, so I hope something else wants to lay down a bit. Well, we'll see. Wow, this is blending out so nicely, and it's laying on top of each other really well. Wow, this is really cool. I just want to get like in the inner crease, I want to have that like green gradient going. Green gradient. I work for the government, so I am, and I've been working for the government for like 10 years. And I've noticed that my company, the company I work for, that is like government owned, or yeah, like government owned, it's government owned. It's very normal to have a very diverse group of people working there. So all my colleagues are from, you know, everywhere, all walks of life. I live in a city, I live in Rotterdam. In Holland, Rotterdam even has more non-Dutch people than there are, more non-Dutch people than there are Dutch or Dutch heritage people here living. So for me, it's one of the most normal things in the world to have like a diverse society around me, where I am interacting with, you know, everyone. That was really surprising to me when that whole, when George Floyd got murdered, and there was this like, check your privilege and make sure you're known about, and make sure you get knowledgeable about what happens to black people, especially in America. And I was like baffled, and I never really, of course I knew there is racism, I get it, there's racism in Holland as well, but I never realized how deeply rooted that is. So if you're black, you're a black woman, and you are a mother, that you have to, or a father, and you have to teach your children how to interact with the cops, because otherwise you get killed. And that was so baffling and scary to me that I was like, whoa. And like the same thing with, if you are from a neighborhood that doesn't have a lot of money, and that is 9 out of 10 times it is, or 8 out of 10 times, I'm sorry, I don't know the statistic, but if you're black, then chances are that you're coming from a neighborhood that is not that rich. I think the fact that if you are from a certain neighborhood, you are going to have more or less chances depending on how rich that neighborhood is, that is like, why do you have that system? It's like mind-boggling to me that you have a system like that. Why? You want people to go to college, and you want people to be smart and be contributing to your economy, but somehow, and it does put black people or people of color a lot more behind white people. I'm going to get the Nomad palette, it's this one, And I'm going to go in with this deep green. I'm going to use the same brush. I'm just going to flip it and I'm going to use the same brush. And I'm going to put this in my outer corner. I think that is a very nice combo of colors. Yes, it is. Ooh, nice. So that is something that really made me sad. And I was like, oh my God, it's always going to take a lot of work for society to change. Be better, you know, just be better. You have to be better about that as a society, but also as a human being, be better. I'm going to go into Green Valley and I'm going to put that in my outer corner. This is from the Safari Rain Palette. I know why this is a cult favorite. My gosh, this palette is stunning. Okay, I am going to, it's very green. And I'm going to see, I think I want to combine it with a little bit of gold. This one, and I'm going to use that in my inner corner. This is a very nice shade to have as like a transition and have like a slightly lighter inner corner. I drew on a little bit of liner. I took my MAC fluid liner in shade. It's a very nice dark green. And I am going to go over to my OPV Beauty pigment right now. And I'm going to use this very neon one. And what I want to do is just extend that wing a little bit with this. And what I'm going to try to do is make a little bit of a liner with this Myali Beauty pigment and glitter primer. And then mix it with this and then make, I hope, a liner. It's a bit messy. Oh great, I messed up my liner. That is not on OPV Beauty, that's just my skills. So, but I thought this would have been a fun little accent type of number, but no. I'm going to go and get a wipe and I'm going to see if I can fix this a little bit. Well, that was fun. I need to really work on my chemistry skills, apparently. I'm not good at this. This is, no. I'm going to try it some other time. All right, I've primed my face and I'm going to use the Fenty, what is this? The Pro Filter Hydrating Longwear Foundation in the shade 185. I'm just going to use a beauty blender and I'm going to tap it all over. This is a very nice foundation. I bet you heard of it. It's very pretty. I'm going to just stipple it on with my beauty blender. The thing though, if you use a beauty blender with this foundation, it doesn't go very far, so you need a lot. And that is, keep that in mind. Right now, I think it is really important that we keep fighting the Black Lives Matter fight, because it needs to be done, because it's still not good. It's still not good. And yeah, sure. I agree, all lives matter. Of course, all lives matter. But right now, we need to fight this fight. And at some point, you have to say, okay, you know what? We're going to have that conversation. And we have to have the conversation in a broader spectrum. Because not only Black people are being discriminated against in this world. But that's a whole nother story. I am going to use this concealer by Juvia's Place. This is in the shade number 19. I haven't used it yet. And it's called I Am Magic Concealer. Whoa, that doe foot is huge. My rule of thumb normally is that you don't need too much. I'm going to zoom you out a little bit. I'm working on my base, I can zoom you out. Going to use a sponge. I think it is a little bit much. What I use, but you know. Oh no, it's a bit much. It's a bit much. It doesn't do my like old under eyes any good if I use a lot of concealer, but it's a nice formula. I'm going to use a little bit of powder and I'm just going to use the Fenty Pro Filter Powder in Butter. I'm also going to use the Fenty Bronzer. This is the Shady Biz shade, because I don't have a bronzer from any other Black owned makeup brands. You see what I mean? I really have to shop some more because there needs to be more in my collection. I am going to use an eyeshadow as a blush because I don't have a blush either. And I am going to try and use this from the Douce palette from Juvia's Place as a blush. Come save me. Okay, I'm going to tap in very lightly, like bing. Okay. Oh yeah, that works. There's a lot on there. Oh, I have to be very careful because there's a lot on there. But this looks cute, right? Wow. Look at me being smart. I'm also going to use this shade Tarte, I think, as my highlight. There, I do that. Ooh, yeah, right there. Because it's a little bit like, it's pinkish. Oh, that's nice. Okay, yes. Yes, please. This is really nice. Wow. It's like a multifunction palette. I didn't know. I want to go over to lips. I have three lipstick from Propa Beauty. I have Finesse. I have Victress and Limitless. I want to try all three of those. And I have a lippy by Color Rain. So I want to try these. I think I'm going to go from light to dark and then see what the Color Rain lippy does. And then we'll decide what I'm going to wear. I'm going to start off with Finesse. That looks like this. I bought this these on National Lipstick Day. This is the shade. The point is so pointy. Well, this is a stunning shade. Wow. This is Finesse. And what I think is so funny is that it almost looks like a plastic bullet. But it goes on your lips so smoothly. It's so nice. Ooh, it's already smudgy. I'm making a mess already. So this is Finesse. And this is the lightest of the three. Then I'm going into Victress. And that is this shade. You see what I mean? It's like almost plastic. I'm going to... The shape of that point, like this shape, fits your lips so well. It's so nice to put them on. Wow. I thought this shade would be so much darker, but it's not. I really love it. This is a stunning shade. It matches my shirt very well. Wow. All right. Then the last shade is Limitless, and it's, I think, a little bit more orange. To be honest with you, I never expected that these were going to be this stunning. I didn't expect these to be so flattering on my skin tone. I expected it to be a little bit like harsh because it's mainly catered to deeper skin tones. But girl, they did something with this. Or she, is it a she? I think it's a she. My God, this is stunning. And the formula, it's so creamy, it's so nice and satiny. Love it. I'm still debating on what I want to wear. Then the next one is from Colored Rain, and this is in the shade Queendom, and it's also quite dark and orange. So I'm really in, and these come in this stunning, like, I'm going to show you the packaging. The packaging is really stunning. Look at this. You've got Colored Rain over there. Really pretty. It's cardboard, so that is really nice. It's recyclable. And then, oh yeah. This is way more matte. Oh, but it's really pretty. The application isn't too good, but look at this color. It's like an orangey red color, like a deep clay color. It's so stunning. Look, with this green. Really nice. I love it. Oh my gosh, I love this. I'm going to go and put this Propa Beauty lipstick on because I think that it's distracting me. The lips are distracting me. So I'm going to put this Victress shade on from Propa Beauty, and I will be back to talk about what I think of the products. First off, the Safari Rain palette. This palette, I'm sorry that it's limited edition, guys, and that it's gone, but this palette, seriously, is so worth the hype. This is a stunning palette. The shades performed so nicely. I love it. I love this look. And nobody was looking weird at me for wearing this type of look, so it's very work appropriate. You could totally wear this to work. Then I also used the Nomad and the Tribe palette for some under eye action and some action in the crease, and I think they performed really, really nice as well. And of course, I had the Douce palette to provide me with a little bit of blush and a little bit of highlighter. Also stunning. I love how this came out. I love that this is such a multifunction palette. I don't think I could be, no, I can't really get a bronzer out of here, but you know, if there was a bronzer shade in here, I didn't need to bring anything else. That is great. The foundation, we all know and love it. It's the Fenty one. It's beautiful. The Juvia's Place concealer, I was very surprised with. I have to finick a little bit with this because I have very like crepey under eyes. I didn't use my Becca under eye primer. This might help, but what I really love about this is that it's quite creamy and the coverage is really good because this time I didn't color correct with any peachiness. And look at this. It's extremely bright as well, but it's the coverage is really nice. So I am really impressed by this concealer. I am going to wear this a lot more. Then the OPV Beauty. I had two of these little liner thingies, pigment thingies. This is something I just have to work with. It's my fault that it didn't work. I have to, you know, make sure that I know how. I also had some lashes, but I think they are a little bit too much for a workday. So I'm not going to wear those. Then I had the Fenty Beauty powder. I do love this powder. I just don't like it on my under eye. That is something I decided and found out in this video. Then the Colored Rain lippy, stunning lippy. It's very matte, but it didn't feel too drying on my lips for that 30 seconds I had it on. But I think this is a stunning shade, very beautiful. And I think the formula is really nice as well. But these Proper Beauty ones, these Proper Beauty ones and this palette for me are the heroes of this video. I love these and I love this. Oh my God, I am going to wear the heck out of these things and the heck out of this palette. This is my new go-to. I love it. It is so stunning and it's right up my alley because you know I love green eyeshadow. Okay, so I'm just going to finish off. I loved trying all these products. As I said, I am going to definitely dabble more in Black-owned makeup brands. And not because I think, you know, I want to be the holier than holy. I don't care about that. I think these are stunning, genuinely stunning. And I want to support the cause, or I want to support Black-owned makeup brands. Also, what I want to say on everything I touched on, please be civil down in the comments. It's my opinion, it's my own feelings. I think it is very important to have a conversation. So if you want to have that conversation with me, don't be scared to leave a comment down below. But please keep it civil, because otherwise I will just, you know, toss the thing away. I'm not here for that bullshit. Okay, then thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked what you saw. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye!